The openings begin now with Sucrum's Brewing Company Starbeast Imperial Stout. 10.5% alcohol. Wow. They describe it as a complex and full-bodied imperial stout with hints of dark chocolate molasses and a resinous hop bite. Resin. Wow. That is powerful. I like it. So what is the first thing in here? It calls itself 3D printer parts. Okay. Looks like a replacement nozzle. Here's what's special about this one. Most nozzles just have a single inlet for the filament on the back. This one has three inlets. So this part is going to be hot and will be melting the filament. So it kind of splits the filament into three paths and allows it much more contact with the heat to bring it up to temperature, up to full temperature quickly. And apparently that causes you to get more flow. You can push more filament through faster, which equates to faster printing without causing problems. One piece 3D printer nozzle for 1.75 millimeter filament E3D V6 clone. Okay, that's, I think, the real company that made the real one. CHT tip nozzles, brass, copper print head, 0.4 millimeter high flow. $2.64. Wow. I got the 0.4 millimeter. You can go all the way down to 0.2 or up to 1 millimeter. And I expect you could just chuck the filament through the thing at 1 millimeter. But you'd lose some level of detail. But anyway, I got the 0.4 millimeter. And yeah, there is the magic trick about this thing. So the good thing, I guess, is that they're not even pretending that they haven't cloned it. So they're being at least that honest, I guess. Other than that, there is all the specs. 3.0 Mohs hardness. If that means anything to you, the different nozzle sizes available. Works up to 300 Celsius. 200 is typical PLA temperature, so that should be fine. They call it brass and copper. I don't know which part's brass and which part's copper, or if they're just covering their butts with the description. So just for full disclosure, here is the actual one from the company that actually designed it. And you notice that there's a much sharper entry for the filament there. This is the Bontec CHT nozzle, just for reference. And they're saying that they cost about $20. So, yeah, that's... Well, you have to make your decision for yourself. And I may end up getting one of those if I like the technology. If it doesn't do anything for me, then I've only wasted a couple of bucks. At least that's how I see it.
All right, next thing in calls itself Serial Port Wi-Fi Test Board. Serial Port Wi-Fi Test Board. Is that, what is this? Oh, it's an RP2040. See that logo there? This is the chip that is on the Raspberry Pi Pico microcontroller. But in a form factor that reminds me of this little AT Tiny guy here, the DigiSpark board. Of course, with many more pins broken out on it. Not all of the pins that the RP2040 can do. There's the Pi Pico for comparison. It has many more pins broken out, but in this cool little form factor, I think that's pretty neat. What is this chip on the back, though? I don't recognize that guy. Windbond 25037, etc. Pi Pico doesn't have anything like that on it, I don't think so. Is that extra memory, or is that doing something else interesting?
RP2040-One Development Board, USB Type-A port, 4 meg flash, plug-and-plays, dual-core, TE, whatever. $7.92 with $2.83 shipping, so best part of 10 bucks for this guy. RP2040 microcontroller, yeah, we knew that. Built-in 264K of SRAM and 4 meg of onboard chip flash. What do we got going on here? Oh, okay. So that is flash on the back. All right. And then on the front is, of course, the RP2040. Sure. What do we got for pins? It's not saying. Oh, there is a WS2812 on there as well. So an addressable LED. Okay. So there's the GPIO that it breaks out. It has 0 to 13 and 14, 15, and then 26, 27, 28, and 29. So, like I said, there is a handful that aren't available, but, oh, wait, no. There they are. They're just on surface pads. Okay, I stand corrected. So they are all available. Just some of them are less convenient than others, I guess. Suppose you could splodge a piece of ribbon cable onto there or something to break those out if you wanted to. Regardless, in this form factor, I think it's pretty interesting. It's smaller than the Pi Pico, does all the same things, and no cables required. Just plug it in. Next thing in, it says gear. Oh, could this be the parts for my Roomba already? Maybe. That'd be cool. That didn't take too long. Yes, that is the replacement gears for my Roomba. Which one is it? This is the gear that I actually need. If you recall, this top gear here is stripped out on it. I don't strictly need this one, but it's good to have. They mesh nicely. Cool. And so far, my 3D printed gear hasn't failed, although we haven't been using it all that much. We've been using the manual vacuum and the teenagers for most of the cleaning, but the Roomba's had a few hours on it, and so far, the gear hasn't fallen apart yet. I'll let you see it when I change it out, I guess. Two pieces blue side brush motor gear replacement gear for iRobot Roomba 5, 6, and 7 series. Mine is a 6 series. This cost me $9.17 with free shipping. Woohoo! I will link you to the video where I tore down the Roomba and discovered that this gear right here was damaged and what I did about it. And sometime in the near future, there will be another video, I guess, just a quick one when I drop these gears in. It really doesn't take very long to do it. It's like half a dozen screws. It's designed to be serviced. It's a very nice device. All right, next in, it doesn't say, at least not in English, what's in here, so I have to do it the hard way. Oh, it's a couple little samples of, glowing filament, glow-in-the-dark filament. Oh, that's cool. So I got 10 meters of blue and 2 meters of orange. The orange looks, to my eyes, a little muted. I wouldn't have called that orange if it didn't say orange on there. Well, when I'm going to let these charge up under my studio lights here for a while, and we'll just see near the end of the video how glowy they really are. Glow PLA filament 3D printer printing glowing ABS, glowing dark PCL. No, I didn't get polycarbonate, I didn't get ABS, I got PLA, although these guys have got everything. So the 10 meter samples that I got are $4.27 Canadian each. For a full kilogram, it's $47. So that's why I decided to go with just a 10 meter sample initially, just to see if I like it, to see if it prints well, or if I think it prints well. And yeah, just to experiment. Because $4 is a cheap experiment. And as always, the last package in is the largest package. And this one doesn't say what it is at all. It came from one of the Canadian reshipping warehouses, so of course there's no customs declaration on it. It is well packaged in foam, though. This wasn't intended to be a mailbag item. This is a sponsored, donated review sample, I guess. Interesting. FNIRSI USB fast charging tester. This is their FNB48P. Okay. So it looks like it can handle up to 24 volts, which is well above the fast charging. 6.5 amps, 156 watts.
360-degree screen flip, interfaces USB-A, USB-C, and micro USB. Now I've got an assortment of USB testers, this Unity one, this absolutely cheapest possible charger doctor, this KiwiSci, whatever name, kind of no-name one, which was my go-to one for quite a while, and these guys are fairly accurate, or at least close enough anyway, but this one apparently has a few other tricks up its sleeve, and it can control the power delivery stuff to get into the higher voltages, and yeah, it has a few other things that it can apparently do, but we will save this until, actually, let's do it this coming Friday and do an actual closer look at it, to do the review.
FNIRSI FNB58, FNB48P, USB charger, voltmeter, ammeter, Type-C fast charging detection, trigger capacity measurement, ripple measurement. It appears that I got the 48P with Bluetooth. On AliExpress, this thing's going for $57.05 plus a little bit of shipping. I'll try and put a few more links down below if I can find them, if I can find the official link that they sent me. And if there's any discount codes that they offer me, I will put them down there, or they'll be with the video on the weekend if I can't find it that quickly. So the 48P model, which is the one that I've got with the optional Bluetooth, here is all the specs. I'm not going to read this all because this will take all night, and this isn't the review or feature video anyway. But it has interfaces for USB-A, USB-C, and micro USB, 1.7-inch clear definition display, measure voltage curves, interesting. There is the specs, up to 24 volts, up to 6.5 amps, or up to 156 watts with 5 digits of precision. What else we got? Cable resistance measurement. That could be useful for checking out some of these flaky USB cables I got around here, or some of these cheap ones that I buy. Maybe some of them are better than I thought. So yeah, there is our type A in and out, type C in and out, and micro USB in. Okay. Oh, there's a computer interface as well. So you can either talk to it remotely and record data, I guess, remotely by Bluetooth or by computer. Interesting. I'm going to have to see what the software available is. Oh, don't even have to tear it down to find out what's inside it. 240 meg ARM processor, MF4 series. Okay. It's got a little oscilloscope mode in it for ripple. Wow. Didn't expect that. Anyway, there's a lot going on here. There's some more specs. I will have to do a closer look at this thing when I do the more in-depth video. Stay tuned.
Well, they do glow, but it's not a super bright glow. In a completely dark room, you can absolutely see them. But with any lights on, you can't really see it glowing. I don't know, maybe once it's out of the package and extruded, it'll be a little bit more impressive. We shall find out. And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Varied as always. It's cheap samples of glow-in-the-dark 3D printing filament just to play with. The gears for my Roomba came in quicker than I expected. That's good. This little nozzle, as I said, it is a cheap knockoff of the real thing. I'm not sure how into the high-speed technology I want to get or how well that's going to work, but we'll play with it anyway. If I really like it, I'll probably spring for the real one for $20, but for now, the $2 knockoff will work. And then there is this Raspberry Pi, well, RP2040 board. I like that form factor. Should be fun to play with. And it is just a really capable little chip for a microcontroller. And of course, the USB tester. This, as I said, is a review sample, which we'll be getting a closer look at coming up later this week. Stay tuned for that. Well, thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks to my Patreon supporters and my YouTube channel members who helped me buy this stuff. And of course, keep the beer fridge full. Very important. Thanks to everybody else for watching. Comments and questions down below. As always, I'll talk to you later.